My name is Gulen Amichama. I have a law degree from the University of Hargeisa and a master's degree from the University of Hargeisa on international relations and diplomacy. I'm currently studying peace and conflict studies from the University of Hargeisa, a master's degree level. I'm also studying master's degree on international law. I grew up and studied all my life in Gaya, Somaliland, but I was born in Senegal region, east of Somaliland. When I graduated from law school in 2010, I joined the University of Hargeisa Legal Aid Clinic as an internship. And from there, I have learned and realized the difference between the theory we learned at the school and the practice at the courts. What was happening with the courts and the police and the justice sector in general shocked me as a law student or as a person who is studying in Somalia. And from there, I took the mission to contribute in development of the Somalian legal system and protection of human rights. Along with other colleagues and students, we tried a number of things. But last time, we realized to form a human rights organization because in a democratic country, absence of a human rights watchdog is not a good thing. We should have a strong civil society that can challenge the state and can speak on behalf of the society, on behalf of the people who their rights are deprived by the state. Therefore, in January 2013, we were able to register a human rights center, which I am now the chairperson. And a human rights center is basically a local human rights organization, whom is built by volunteers, lawyers who are volunteers, to defend and protect the human rights in Somalia. Our main reference is the Constitution of the Republic of Somalia and the Universal Declaration of the Human Rights, which we do believe all the governments and institutions in the world should follow and protect the rights that are enshrined in the Universal Declaration of Human Rights and the Constitution of Somalia. Since 2013, we have been involved in a number of advocacy and human rights monitoring activities. Very recently, we issued a quarterly report on the situation of media in Somalia, where we have released that 11 journalists were arrested in Somalia in the last 4 months. One journalist was prosecuted, and 5 websites were blocked by court. In an election period, we are very concerned on that incident that happened in Somalia, because we think, as the Constitution says, and the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, media freedom should be fully respected, and the government should decriminalize media and stop using the penal court, the outdated penal court, on media issues, because Somalia has a just law and it has a very beautiful and good constitution. Yes, we have a difficulty with the government because of 2 reasons. Number one, the rule of law is very weak, and in a situation where the rule of law is very weak, the government authorities, when they become upset, they're able to act to take an action without due process of law. And secondly, in Africa in general, and in Somalia in particular, human rights is not an easy job. If you work with human rights, it means you are challenging the government, you are challenging the people in power, who are very likely to abuse and misuse the power. And in relation to the police, what we did was our police is highly centralized in the institution. That goes back to, in terms of formation, structure, and laws, to the Siya Barre era. What we suggested is that, can we gather the people of Somaliland and write a petition and ask the government of Somaliland to reform the police in a manner that is consistent with the constitution of Somalia? Instead of us asking that, we believe that organizing the community will be better. Therefore, we introduced a petition. But the petition upset the government, particularly the police. And that's why my colleague was arrested and I was prosecuted. That's how it happened. And we were very sorry that it went into that far, because we never intended to agitate anyone or to upset anyone. We just wanted to have a better, beautiful police that can do their job better, that can get a better salaries, but also can treat people better, that can respect and uphold the institution. That's what happened in relation to the police. We negotiated with the police, we took it to the parliament as well, and we are hoping in the near future, or the short term, the politicians will come up with a solution to reform of the police.
The government has its own human rights commission. How do you interact with this commission? And are you confrontational? Do you cooperate, or can you brief us on that?
We have a law that established the Human Rights Commission. And according to the law, the Human Rights Commission should be independent. But practically, the National Human Rights Commission is not independent. It is a governmental, and they are highly politicized institution. Therefore, we try to cooperate, and we work with them very closely all the time, because we, all of us, have to work together. But they are not doing their job, basically. Their term expired a long time ago. Therefore, even they exceeded the period, unfortunately. And it is a practice and culture in Somaliland that any institution can stay longer than they are elected or nominated. But we have to work with them, and still we continue working with them. We hope in the future the commission is strengthened and made more independent, so that they can do their job better and we can cooperate with them better. But now it is a political organ of the government. When we founded HRC in 2013, we were very ambitious. But we were very young law graduates who didn't have a connection, who didn't have money, who didn't have expertise and experience running an organization. But now, 5 years later, we have a strong human rights advocacy organization that is fully functional, operational organization that has a presence in all the regions of Somaliland. We have meetings in all the 6 regions of Somaliland. We are able to monitor and document human rights violations. We are able to advocate. Still, there are very huge weaknesses within our service, which we should go beyond it, including a shortage of personnel, shortage of expertise and experience as well, and also financial problems. But the big achievement is that we now have an organization that's functioning in Somalia.
Where do you get funds from? Partners.
When we started the Human Rights Center in 2013, before we did that, we did have our own research. We asked ourselves why the human rights organization in Somaliland don't survive. And we come up with two reasons. Number one, most of the human rights organizations in Somaliland are huge, with so many numbers. And governments are able to use members of the organization to dismantle it internally to create conflict. That's one reason. The second reason is that majority of the human rights organizations are project-driven. They are entirely personal projects.
And
for that reason, because they are based on projects, they can't survive if they don't have the project. To get a solution for this two-man problem, we shortened the number of people who are members of the Human Rights Center. We have a very small group of human rights defenders who have a passionate commitment for human rights, number one. Number two, we don't rely on donor projects. For that reason, most of the activities for Human Rights Center are based on volunteers and member individuals who are committed to do the work of voluntary basis. Therefore, they do a small time of their work and they volunteer. Members also have to pay a subscription fee all the time and donations. Apart from that, we have a partnership with the National Endowment for Democracy, which is a good organization that works with us, international media support, and very recently, Amnesty International has supported us by giving training to regional monitors, and they gave really very good and informative training that will help us to have a better monitoring and documentation.
Mr. Guled, sometimes back we covered you at a conference in Dublin, Ireland. Can you tell us about it?
It was a very outstanding and interesting conference in Dublin. It was in November 2015. It was organized and hosted by Frontline Defenders, an international organization that defends the rights of human rights defenders. They defend us. And the organization brought together 100 to 120 human defenders all over the world. It was very interesting to be with the people who